Hi, I'm Matthew Yi, Technical Marketing Manager at Red Hat, and I'm going to tell you about Red Hat Satellite 6.13, estimated to become generally available in May 2023. Satellite 6.13 intends to refine and improve operations while introducing new features to make managing and deploying Red Hat Enterprise Linux as efficient as possible. From new user interface refinement to content synchronization features, 6.13 makes it easier than ever to make sure your customer and user-facing applications are running smoothly on top of a stable Red Hat Enterprise Linux foundation on-premises or in hybrid cloud environments. First, we'll go over the UI improvements in Satellite 6.13. The host menu can now be customized to display host information required by you to do your job. As you can see, you can select from categories such as content, network, reported data, and Red Hat Cloud. There is a new report that will display the difference in errata between two different versions of a content view. In the video, we view the difference between version 1 and 2 of the content view. We can see what errata are added to version 2 of the content view. There are several enhancements to the host details page: hardware properties, registration information, BIOS version, OS version, and virtualization information are now visible in all these cards. Should you wish, the legacy UI is still available through the kebab button in the top right-hand corner. There's a new Ansible job report which provides information such as the successes or failure status and details as to the tasks performed, amongst other things. Report generation can be triggered via webhook. In this video, you can see a report showing all of the details of the Ansible job that was executed. In 6.13, you can now generate a report that lists all the installed packages for a host. This makes it really easy to figure out what software you have installed on a particular host. We have further enhanced remote execution pull mode in Satellite 6.13. Remote execution pull mode, or REX pull, was introduced in Satellite 6.12. In the 6.13 release, REX pull can queue jobs for hosts that are periodically offline or disconnected from the satellite capsule server. When the host is brought online and connected again, the queued job will be picked up from the capsule server and run. As well, REX pull can now run jobs with the run as flag so that you can run jobs as other users. The UI for creating and scheduling a remote execution job has also been enhanced, making it a clearer process. This video shows the new UI for creating remote execution jobs, regardless of pull or push mode. You can see that the process for creating a new job is now guided with clear steps to reduce errors and confusion. For those of you using Catello Agent, please remember that it was deprecated in Satellite 6.7. We are planning on removing it completely from Satellite 6.15. In order to keep using remote execution, you can use REX push through SSH, or you can configure REX pull mode before upgrading to Satellite 6.15. The Satellite Ansible collection now includes support for creating content exports. Red Hat provides an Ansible collection that enables you to write Ansible playbooks to deploy and configure Red Hat Satellite, saving you time and effort. The Satellite Ansible collection contains Ansible modules that can be used to construct playbooks to perform satellite-related tasks. In 6.13, the collection includes a new module to export content to be used to update offline or disconnected satellite servers or capsules. You can use this module to export libraries, content view versions, and repositories. This feature now makes it easy to export content in a repeatable and consistent manner. We have also improved the alternate content sources feature in 6.13. Satellite 6.13 makes it easier to synchronize from alternate content sources, or ACSs. ACSs are used to make more efficient use of bandwidth when synchronizing content. There are two new improvements to ACS in Satellite 6.13. The first is the addition of web GUI functionality to setting up synchronization with Red Hat update infrastructure sources. The second is the addition of a new source type known as simplified. A simplified ACS source can be created for any content product. This is an example of how ACS is used to synchronize content and metadata. In this example, we have a satellite and capsule server in different data centers. Both servers can access the Red Hat Update Infrastructure, or Red Hat CDN. In this diagram, content and metadata are synchronized from the CDN to the satellite server. Suppose we are synchronizing content between the satellite server and the capsule server in the second data center. Without ACS, we would have to transfer the content and metadata between the satellite and capsule server. With ACS, we can save bandwidth. Metadata is synchronized between the satellite and capsule server, while content is synchronized directly with the Red Hat CDN. To clarify, here are three ACS types supported by satellite. The custom ACS type is used for custom repositories. The Red Hat Update Infrastructure ACS is used for synchronizing RUI content. The new simplified ACS enables you to create ACSs for any Red Hat product served through the Red Hat Content Delivery Network. In 6.13, we have several inter-satellite sync improvements. To refresh everyone's memory, this chart provides a summary of the different modes of inter-satellite sync. Syncable exports are different from ISS Export Sync in that they are available in YUM format. Previously, the ISS Export Sync would create exports in a pulp content format. This means that you can now host the syncable exports content over HTTP and synchronize a capsule with it. This method of providing content does not require that capsule and satellite servers run on the same version of software. In 6.13, satellite will now automatically create satellite artifacts like content views and then add subscriptions when importing the syncable export. As well, Docker repositories are supported. And here are some little bites, which are small changes in 6.13 that make a big difference. We have simplified host registration with a load balancer. This removes the extra steps needed to register a host with a load balanced capsule. Simplified content access is now enabled for newly created organizations by default. You can now search for hosts by insights status. Thank you.